Hi, once again, I'm here to discuss the chapter 5. Chapter 5 in our spirit is the last chapter, which is summary, conclusion, and recommendation. You cannot make this unless otherwise you did not finish everything done. So in this matter, I already done the chapter 1, teaching you, then the chapter 2, then the chapter 3, then the chapter 4, and finally the chapter 5. Okay? In chapter 5, it is about the summary, conclusion, and recommendation. We have to start with the title first, so that we are aware and we know what we will go into to start with. First and foremost, the title is Student Satisfaction on the Services of College of Business Administration of the UPSSD. It means the University of Perpetual Health System, Delta, Molino Campus, and Cavite, Philippines. A basis for improving the student services area for PAKUKUWA accreditation. As I said, when we say PAKUKUWA, it is the Philippine Association of Colleges and Universities Commission on Accreditation. First, I introduce to you in Chapter 1. What is this accreditation all about? This accreditation, the colleges and universities in private, in the public schools, in order to have the quality education, they must accredit their schools to the accrediting body of the PAKUKUWA. And take note that PAKUKUWA, an accreditation is voluntarily doing. It means it is the discretion of any schools, university, colleges, if they want to be accredited. If they do not want, it's up to them. But if you want the good quality, you be accredit your school so that it could be the best schools in your community. Okay, in Chapter 1, I discussed the introduction. They have the background already. In Chapter 2 again, I let you know about the related literature of the study, that there are related studies come out with the accreditation. Okay, I make it a point to you, my future researchers, that the literature should be 1/4 of the research consists of literature. That's why I let you know to add an information, the related studies, the local and the foreign studies, and I hope you understand that all. Okay, in that aspect, I am particular about the different areas in the different areas of accreditation. In different areas, we have 9 areas supposed to be. So, what are the 9 areas or 10 areas to be exact? First areas in accreditation that the university and colleges should consider, because it matters in this summary, conclusion, and recommendation. The first area, it should be the philosophy and objectives. You must know the philosophy and objectives of your schools, university, or colleges in order to go on with your voluntary accreditation level. Second, the faculty. The faculty is very important. Why the faculty is the second? You cannot go on with any institution unless no faculty are involved. Because this faculty will serve as the tool to mold students and every aspect of their lives inside the university. So the faculty should be selected from the different numbers of applicants. Every semester, every year, there are applicants, and the human resource department used to apply themselves to become faculty. In order to be accepted in any colleges, the faculty teaching in college should be has a master's degree, and definitely they have to finish a master's degree. The first requirement it is. And our university, all faculties finish already their master's degree. And some has the doctoral degree finished, and some are still studying with the doctoral degree. So this is the second area of accreditation. So the third area is instruction. Why instruction? Instruction is important because if there are faculties in your college, make sure that their instruction are good quality because they are teaching the students well. If they used to teach the students, they have to mold them accordingly to the instruction given to them. Okay? And next is the laboratory. Why laboratories is also important? You cannot go on with any lecture without laboratory equipment, without laboratory room. Why? Because out of the lecture papers that you are doing, you have to do that in the laboratory room. You tell the students, this is on how it goes. If we do not have laboratory, how can it be? So then after the laboratory, the research, number five. I myself, as I mentioned before, as a research coordinator and a research professor in the university, I do my research every semester, and I make it a point that I submitted it to the Research Development Center of the university. And the research that I am teaching you now is the research being presented in the PACUCOA accreditation. Okay? Then, after the research, it should be the library. You cannot go on with college, university, operations without library. And the library, it should be equipped. Equipped with what? Equipped with books. Not only book, but book. A lot of book. Whatever the needs of your students, you have to sustain the different kinds of books. Books, manuals, magazines, journals, publications, and even internet aspects called the library should have be possible to have that in their library section. After the library, the student services. The student services will serve as student guide in order themselves to be fruitful in their studying, because they involve the student activities. We have the student council here. We have the different organization of the students' body. and it is and there is be in it there are faculties who will guide us, their advisors, as far as specialization of any faculties. Okay, the social outreach orientation or the community involvement, in other words, important also because education is not only done inside the classroom. It should also done beyond the classroom. Our university has an adopted community. In this adopted community, we, the group of students, and there is one coordinator who is assigned that they go to a different, not different, they go to a specific adopted barangay. In this adopted barangay, it is a slum area where the families, the four families live. They do not have enough food to share because their source of living is scavenging. Therefore, they usually pick up some garbage, then dump it and put that to the any junk shop and exchange with a little money. So out of that, the children cannot afford to study, but cannot afford even to have good food for their living. So the group of students in our university go here. There is a schedule teaching them on how to feed their children, by feeding them, of course, by giving some lectures, lessons, and giving an alternative program so that it could go on what do they want. They could sustain their lives, in other words. So after this, the other areas, which is the number 9, is the physical facilities or the physical plant and facilities. Important. Why? Students, they want the equipment. The physical facilities of the schools are being consideration in enrollment. They like the new building. They like it is equipped with the different facilities. They like the cold air condition. They like it is the good paint in their surrounding so that it could be conducive for learning. And then lastly, it is the organization and administration. These organizations are the group of management that could create the stay of the to make it the university a funder to live in. So, as I mentioned about this organization, there is a group of the so-called faculty club that they organize the officers, and as well as the group of management that they could work in hand together for the progress of this university. So all of this you have to consider in doing a research if your title is about accreditation like mine. As I mentioned, that my research is about the student satisfactions on the 10 areas of accreditation for the PACOCOA, as I mentioned it before. Now, I have to proceed and let you know the summary, conclusion, and recommendations of my research. And I will make it a point that you must be enlightened on what is my result of this research, as I could say. So summary. In summary, it is the profile of the UPHSD College of Business students. So here, the College of Business Administration students, majority of the students were enrolled in the Bachelor's of Science in Business Administration, major in Marketing Management. There are 127 or 47.21 are females. And it is equivalent to, aside from the females, the one aside from being a female, they are a Tagalogs, which is 220 or 81.78% in terms of the ethnicity. And the Roman Catholics here is 136 or 50.55% in terms of religion, meaning the respondents of my studies dominated by the female and dominated by the Tagalog ethnicity and dominated also by the Roman Catholic. Because in every colleges, as I could see, there are a lot of females. As I mentioned a while ago, that the area belongs to the Tagalog one, therefore most of them came from a Tagalog region. And though it is a Filipino, but they have the different ethnicity. And then the Roman Catholic of a Catholic university is also 50%. Okay? So based on the overall computed mean of 2.35 majorities of the 269, the University of Perpetual Health System Delta colleagues of business administration students were moderately satisfied with the services provided by the university, the area of admission, registration, and orientation. The overall mean of 2.60, the students were satisfied with the services provided by the university along the area of teaching, learning, and assessment, except for the services provided by the research coordinators. Almost all of the students stated that they are moderately satisfied with a mean of 2.42. In other words, with the help of the coordinators and research, I could say it by myself that they are satisfied. Okay? So if I go on. Okay? So the moderate level of satisfaction was the given rate by the UPSSD students, College of Business Administration students, of the services provided to them by the personnel in charge of the student services based on the overall mean, which is 2.62, except for the services provided by the Dean of Student Affairs, which rated us satisfied. Okay? So the Dean of Students Affairs the only satisfied us as far as the student services is concerned. With respect to the services provided by the university along the area of the library, the computed overall mean of 2.43 with qualitative description of moderate level of satisfaction. In this case, we could give a conclusion in summary that only the Dean of Student Affairs, the students are very much satisfied because it is very approachable. Whatever they want, it is being guided and given to them, so they could not be asking anymore for. Likewise, the level of satisfaction of the students to the canteen services, rather, moderate with mean 2.03. The same was also for the services provided by the publishing house with mean of 2.21. The same finding was observed for the information technology services with the overall mean of 2.26. As mentioned by the publishing house and the information technology, that they are also moderately satisfied. And yet, the students, they get their satisfaction as far as their services are concerned also. for the last two services areas, we have the physical facilities and provision of spirituality and religious beliefs services for the students rated almost all of the services provided to them with mean of 2.32 except for item number one, the physical environment of the university, which rated by the senior students as satisfied. Satisfied was also the level of satisfaction with the different services on the provision of spirituality and religious beliefs. Therefore, as I mentioned, all of the services being offered by university to the students, most of them are moderately satisfied, except for the mentioning about the provisions of the spirituality and religious beliefs. Could rather say that most of the students are Catholic and they use the worship of God as being molded by their parents, that they are also doing that whenever they were. But the university is also accepting any kind of student, any kind of religion, as long as they want to study in the university, they are all welcome. In this aspect, they are very much satisfied on what they want from the university. So, as far as the accreditation level is concerned, the university passed with flying colors. I myself could testify to that because I am present during the accreditation rites, and the accreditors used asking questions to me regarding the not only in research but every aspect and the accreditation area. Okay, I proceed. I am now on my conclusion. As far as conclusion, most of the respondents were enrolled at the Bachelor's of Science and Business Administration, major in Marketing Management. It is considered as a degree. In Tagalog, is there ethnicity? And the Roman Catholic for their religion, and female as the gender or sex of the students. Okay. I could rather say that most of the students, they want the marketing management degree as their field of specialization, because major in marketing management, it is flexible in all aspects. Why flexible? If you graduate from this course, the students are knowledgeable enough in a marketing field in the sales industry. Because there are students used to take their on-the-job training, taking an on-the-job training in the industry, in the sales itself. I have one of my students who undergo training in the sales company of Toyota. In Toyota, they usually know the going of a certain agent, because they have a place in a mall. They giving such brochures, interviewing prospect clients who want to get car. Then at the end of that, our students, when they graduated, they are encouraged in have a part time selling cars. They could sell, actually, my previous students. Other students, they have an OJT in a different field. Most of them in a marketing industry, but they excel in their own way. Aside from they have a good speaking knowledge, because in the classroom they are being molded by the languages, speaking to people, reporting to the classmates with the help of the multimedia, the PowerPoint presentation also that they have. And they are also with their business attire doing it, and they usually face the panel with questions as part of their curriculum, as part of their curriculum requirements, I should say. That's why there are a lot of marketing management students. The Tagalog belongs to the southern part of the Philippines. So most of the language speak Tagalog. Though there are Tagalog and aside from Tagalog, they belong to the ethnic groups of Tagalog, that they do not have any, let's say, going to Visayas or to the Muslims or to the Igorot or to the Maranao. But most of them, because the school itself is located at the center in Manila. Okay, that is the ethnic group. The Roman Catholic, as I should say, it is a Catholic school, therefore, there are a lot of enrollees, not only in our college, but even in other colleges. He also dominated by the Roman Catholic. The female, of course, I tell it a while ago that I could rather conclude that in every schools or in any activities, there are more females rather than the males. Maybe because we are the males are outnumbered, more males rather than females. The number two conclusion is they were moderately satisfied. Okay, so in terms of satisfaction, the moderately satisfied with the services provided by the UPHSD, the University of Perpetual Health System, with the areas of admission and registration, the teaching, the learning and assessment, the student services, library services, information technology services, canteen services, publishing house, as the inventory management office, information technology, services, physical facilities, and provision for spirituality and religious belief. It is dominated by moderately satisfied, except perhaps with the student affairs services, which is the Dean of Student Affairs, who got the satisfactory grade that the students could embrace the committee, the deans of the student affairs, in all aspects of accreditation. And lastly, for the spirituality, I could rather say that the students are in good values, because they are being molded by their parents from their houses with good values. That's why they come out with spirituality and religious belief as a satisfactory rating also. Okay? The recommendations. And recommendations, the following recommendations are to be taken by the university. As far as I am a researcher concerned, aside from the conclusion of the research, I make recommendation. Recommendation regardless of what is being recommended, as long as it is has a relationship, rather, has a relationship in the studies being conducted. So, if future researchers, if you will be doing it, you just take note of the recommendation that you have to consider. So the following recommendations are to be taken by the university. Okay? Number one, under the belief that customers are kings and queens. And since the students of the university are the customers, philosophy, the university should observe in dealing with the students. And in order to assure that this belief is truly observed in its real sense, the administration should conduct seminar workshops on customer relations and adopt a computerized customer relation management, or the so-called CRM. Okay, I will explain why I have this recommendation this way. Simple. In marketing, as dominated by the students, customers are kings and queens. Why we call them? Simple. Customers give us profit. Without customers, the industry is nothing. Who will patronize the product? Who will buy the product? Who will consume the product? Therefore, the customers, that's why we are treated them as the king and queen. It is in the industry. But we are now in school, in the university. So we'll consider this the customer this time. So the customer this time is the students. Why the students? Because they are the ones who give us also profit, revenues, whatever paid by their tuition fee, it goes to the schools, to the university. But not all aspects that we will consider the students are the kings and queens. Why? Because if we're going to do that, we will not have the good quality education. Don't you know why? If we will all follow what the students want, or what is the use of teaching in the classroom if the students will be the one to follow? In this matter, the professor should observe and be also considered as the king and queens inside the classroom. And the students will be molded in a nice way. And you will give the due grade, whatever being due for them. That's why there are students who got good and higher grades. It is based from the assessment of the professors. That's why in the area of consideration, we want the professors in good high profile, so that it could teach the students well their expertise, because this expertise could help to mold them in the students when they get out from the university. When they graduated, they will make their own names, and the universities that they came from will be proud of them, being proud on what they have. And when they return back to their alma maters, they will tell to the professors, to the teachers, thank you, professor, for what being molded to us. So they learn from us. I myself learned my students, and I am also expecting that my students now in front of me will learn from me far as the research is concerned. And I am looking forward that you will be having your own research in the future. I could say it is in the near future. And hopefully you will be the one who will presenting like this to me. And I will be the one who is looking at you that you are presenting your own research. And I hope we will understand with each other. Okay? And as far as the recommendation is concerned, you to recommend about the seminar workshop. The seminar workshop. Although we have the seminar workshop, but not totally with the so-called customer relation management. It's customer relation management, it involves the student's relations with, we have the good rapport to them. Usually we, if we have the seminars, it's only the strategy of teaching in the other new knowledge or strategies. But this time it will involve the customer relation management. Okay? Number two recommendation is for the area of admission, registration, and orientation. The implementation of the enrollment is necessary to reduce the student traffic in a long queue during enrollment period. The possibility of implementing and or enhancing the e-payment should also be explored. Okay. We are now in a new technology. Says that there is no permanent in this world except in change. In changes could make everything be progressive in changes. In teaching, there are innovations, alternatives. Although you are not in the class, you could do teaching. Like the one that we are doing, the one that I am doing. I am teaching in the online way, and the student could learn from it. I am also doing this to my group of students. I am giving an assignment and making an online quiz, an online assignment, and checking it online. It is the way on the strategy of any professor. The teaching and the learning and assessment, you could assist whatever kind of assessment you want to impart to them, and make sure that you have invest effort to it, because in any doings that you want, the effort is important. If you could do that in an effortless, it's nothing. Whatever fruitful that you want to harvest, it should be in a sweet basis if you do that in a hard-shaped way. I hope you understand what I am telling you. So here, as one of my recommendations, could it be possibly for the long run? It is always an experience in the university that during enrollment, the long lines of the students who will enroll, they have to wait for a long period of time. So the eight payments that I could consider, some are doing, they have to pay it on the bank. But if you will pay it today, it would not be credited today. So meaning you will not be officially enrolled today, because in a bank it lasts for 3 working days, because they will validate for your payment through the online basis and through the school. What if it would be an offline? How could it be? So my other enhancement of the e-payment, it should be the direct contact with the bank and the school, that if I have my children, I pay my tuition fee today, right there in them, it is online paid and online officially enrolled my daughter or any of the children I have. So the number three, in the number three recommendation is the service providers along the areas of teaching, learning, assessment should have efforts on how they will make their instructions interesting and stimulating for the students, prepare and update their modules and lessons. With this, the administration should plan to conduct seminars and workshops on professional ethics, the student-teacher's relationship, code of conduct and behavior, in other areas like teaching, effectiveness, etc. Okay. And this matter, I could rather say that, what is this service provider? For areas of teaching, as I mentioned, a certain group of publishers of a book should actually provide a sample of the book that being only used by a group of students, and it is considered as the reference or the text. These service providers will help the students learn in advance, because usually in other universities they have the so-called publishers. They are giving samples of books, and the samples of books giving to the professor or teaching that, then letting the students to buy for this. But some students used to complain the book is very expensive, because the book itself is, I could say, it is an important one, the foreign author, but it is very nice. I myself, I used to have the book, and it is being handed to me by one of my friend who is a publisher. So I have to impart that to my students, and then teach that on that based on the latest techniques. So I am referring to providers. The learning and assessment well should have also a lot of effort, not letting supposed to be the students go the through the semester for reporting, because it's not necessarily could get the real knowledge. Reporting is good, but not do that in a all lecture or in a whole semester. You have to make lectures at the same time. You let the students report, go on reporting and some other activities, or even do the so-called, we have the role playing. So, and lastly, they have to get out from the classroom and visit the different company linkages that could coordinate with the school as well, and then the subject that the professor is teaching, or I could rather say a professional subject. I myself is teaching a professional subject. Okay, so another recommendation is conduct seminars or workshops. This conduct seminars and workshop, it is being done, of course, but this time I want the seminar and workshop to be conducted in a joint session. Group of students and teachers. At the same time, they are present in a seminar, because the topic for that particular seminar is about the student-teacher's relationship. Because the student and teacher's relationship will only based inside the classroom. Do not go beyond that. Meaning, as much as possible, if it is possible, do not have a mutual relationship with your students. Because it's not good in the eye of the people who could know and who could see you. You can make that, but not totally consider the student. Let the student be first finished their studies and become a professional, so that it could boost the morale of the professors, the students as well. Because it's not good if you will be doing that inside the university. You have to conduct by yourself a student, plain student and teacher relationship only. Beyond that, no, I could say. By means of the seminars, workshop, I think it would help in a long way. In looking forward, it should be effective way. The number four recommendation is, there is a need to review the nature and type of involvement of the students' central council that will make them highly visible to the whole student body. It can also be useful that in order to increase students' level of satisfaction in this area, there should an extensive review and evaluation of the services provided by the different offices involved. The people involved in these offices should be asked to attend training on customer service relation and management. In this aspect, I am recommended to the student body. The student body, not to mention the president of the student body of the university, is one of my students. Why did he become the president of the student body of the university? First, from the group of colleges, they selected a group of, I could say, officers. Then the group of officers elected one student body that the students had a say or could speak on behalf of the group of students, the student council. So in this aspect, I would like to recommend that the involvement, when we say involvement, it's involvement in a whole school year. It is not only there because they are president, they are officers, but I want them to be visible because they are a part of the organization. Make it a point that they have to render service in the university to serve the students, their co-students, whatever the other students ask from them as a help. They could help them in the best that they could. Because there are student leaders that they are only visible if there are on occasion, if there are an activity, but not through and through they are there. So I am not referring this to only one, but I am referring this to everybody, because it is possible to have this, but not necessarily they are doing this. As far as recommendations in my research concerns. Okay? So after that, for number 5 recommendation, for the library services, it is strongly recommended that the university provide for additional Xerox or photocopying machine, if possible, to everyone, to every section of the library. And since a large number of students population, it is in the School of Accountancy, a new unit of machine should be installed. As much as possible, all existing units in the library should be repaired. Okay? As far as the survey is concerned, it is the least number of, I could say, good answer from the students, the library. Maybe because the library is located on the fourth floor of the new building, the students do not make it a habit that they are always going there. And if they are going there, if I give assignments to different professors to do the research, they usually visit and stay at the library. But they want to, if they are there, they borrow books. And if they borrow books, some, instead of copying it, they usually photocopy. But in photocopying a book, it costs a long line. Maybe there are only very minimal photocopying machines. If it could add more, it lessens the agony of the students who want to have a photocopy immediately. That is the main reason. So if there are, I think, machine who is not functioning, if it is possible to repair, if it could not be, it should be removed from that certain place, and it should be replaced to a new one. And as I could see, as the accreditation, on the process, and after the accreditation, the other funds, the non-functioning machine are already removed. I see, because I see it. I already removed, and it is being replaced with a new one. So the students will enjoy what the new photocopying machine they want to avail. Number six, sorry for that. Number six is the management staff of the canteen should pay extra attention to the cleanliness and of sanitation, most especially their cooking areas. Care should be given to the cooking utensils. Cleanliness should always be maintained as much as possible. This is also a need to provide for variety of food daily. Training should also be provided on proper handling of food and customer relationships in all canteen staff. In this case, why should I recommend it? Because though I accept canteen is clean, but there are some times when there are a lot of students, customers who are eating, we cannot avoid to make dirt on that. So the maintenance of the canteen, sometimes they could lack of time because they have to attend to other customers also. So I could say additional cleaners and sanitation for the cooking areas. Why the cooking areas? Canteens is very much important aspect because our health lies on that aspect. If we could eat not totally clean, not totally sanitized, it harms not only our body, but it contains us with a disease. So it says that prevention is better than cure. Then, the cooking utensils. The cooking utensils should be, I am referring if it is after fry, I could rather after frying, you easily clean before frying another. Sometimes if there are a lot of customers, you go on continuous cooking in a certain utensil without anticipated for maybe because there are peak hour, or rather I could say it is a peak hour. Okay, so handling of food customers, the canteen could also given due attention, but as I could see when the accreditation that was done, they do that in a good way, because I used to see that. The number seven recommendation is the administration should therefore make a serious analysis the different services, including the service provider, and to develop some plans on how they can further improve the quality of the services. That satisfaction would eventually increase the student's level of satisfaction. It is very important again that we will give much attention and satisfaction to our customers. The students, I could say, they are the one giving us good revenues and profits. So whatever the results of the research, whatever the results of the recommendation, whatever it is, the administration itself should give a due respect and attention, serious analysis to this. Because it helps. I think it helps whatever it is on what is my recommendation and the Pakukuwa accreditation helped also a lot in the university as well, including the four areas of the 10 areas of consideration. So hopefully, if you were researchers, future researchers, if you will be making a research, make sure that your recommendations would be acceptable and would be in line also to your studies. Do not make it a point that your recommendation is out of topic. They will not merit on that. It should be. Okay? And after that, okay, after finishing the chapter 1, the chapter 2, the chapter 3, chapter 4, and finally the chapter 5. If I finish that all, you come out now with the abstract. You cannot come out with any abstract without finishing the research as well. I finished already the chapter 1 to 5. It is being analyzed, it is being concluded, and it's being recommended. This time, I will give you the abstract. When we say abstract, it is the assessment of what is being done in the studies. Because after the abstract, there are a lot of attachments, and it's important that we will have to consider. After having the chapter 5, the research is not yet done. We have other topics to consider. That's why I am presenting now my abstract in order as a future researcher, you could know also how to make your abstract. Okay? So the abstract is the assessment of quality of the services provided by the university, of Perpetual Health System, DALCA, and College of Business Administration, so their students can be best done by the internal stakeholders, most significantly by their students. The study is entitled Student Satisfaction on the Services of the College of Business Administration of the UPSSB Molino Campus as Basis for Improving the Student Services Area for Pakukuwa Accreditation. It was intended to determine the profile, level of satisfaction to the quality of the services of the university and the relation to the level of satisfaction and the respondents with their profile. Okay? I would like to let you know, my dear future researchers, that abstract will only limit to 150 words. This 150 words, it is the summation of all from the chapter 1, starting from the title up to the end. Okay? To finish my abstract, on my last is one. The descriptive correlative method of research was used in the study. A self-made questionnaire was distributed to 269 college students using the Microsoft Excel and computing the percentages, mean, and the standard deviation. Study had the following findings. Respondents were enrolled in the College of Business Administration course or degree. They were moderately satisfied with the services provided by the UPSSB along the areas, admission and registration, teaching, learning and assessment, student services, library services, information technology, canteen services, outreach activities, information technology services, physical facilities, and provision for spirituality and religious beliefs. All of this, it is a descriptive correlating. When we say it is a descriptive correlated, it correlates to the questionnaire that I made, and it is being answered by the respondent. So in this case, I have these keywords. These keywords is important: the university services, student satisfaction. If you are a future researcher, I am telling you this, you have to make also the keywords. The keywords important that everybody could understand what it is. So again, my keyword is the university services student satisfaction. Again, I will return back for them for my next presentation as I go on with the attachment. This time, not necessarily attachment, that a table of contents. Okay? See you. Okay? Okay.